Lord Rama did not will the bridge to be built, though he had the power to do so. Instead, he gave the opportunity for everyone to be part of it, to participate, to serve him, and to redeem themselves. And because all those animals and birds were part of that grand mission of the Lord, they are all remembered even today, and they are all part of history, his story, like Swami says. Being a part of his mission is indeed a great, great fortune for all of us. And this evening, Swami has blessed a boy from grade 9, Sri Satya Sai Vidya Kendra, to address all of us, Yuva Supreet Reddy. He joined here in the Mudanhalli campus 4 years ago and has been an exceptional student, an all-rounder. He's part of the Vedas and also a volunteer in the audio-visual team and is a great orator. Brothers and sisters, Yuva Supreet Reddy to address all of us this evening. Sai Ram.
సుకుమార శరీరం మకుటలోల కుంతలం ప్రసన్న సుందరం హాస్యం సద్గురుం నమామ్యహం. హ్యావింగ్ ఎ సెలెస్టియల్ బాడీ అండ్ వెరింగ్ ద హెయిర్ యాజ్ హిస్ క్రౌన్ అండ్ అ బ్యూటిఫుల్ స్మైల్ అడోర్నింగ్ హిస్ ఫేస్ ఐ బో అట్ ద లోటస్ ఫీట్ ఆఫ్ ద సద్గురు సాయి మై ప్రణామ్స్ అట్ ద లోటస్ ఫీట్ ఫస్ట్లీ ఐ వుడ్ లైక్ టు అ హార్టీ సాయి రామ్ టు వన్ అండ్ ఆల్ సాయి బ్రదర్స్, dear sisters, parents, and respected Murti Anna and Madhu Anna. And firstly, I would like to thank Bhagwan for giving me such a wonderful opportunity to express my feelings to all of you. And to start with, like, if I'm speaking to all of you, it is a very surprising thing for me itself, because today, as it was my birthday, in the afternoon, I had a great opportunity to serve Swami his lunch. That time, I and other two boys' birthdays were there. We took Pada Namaskar of Swami. Swami spoke to all three of us. Then again, when he asked me that, "Nu mundu kuda matladavu kada, you just spoke one year before also, no?" I said, "Swami, yes, Swami." He said that, "Today also you'll speak." I said, "Okay, Swami, I'll speak, Swami." He said, "Okay, speak." Then, after I came out there only, I was in a sudden shock that, oh, what will I speak? Then I thought, okay, Swami is in my heart. He'll only speak through me. And with that hope, I have come here today and standing in front of you all. Swami, what can I speak about other than you and your love? Because your love is everything here. The creation is only it's because of your love. So today, I would like to speak about your love, Swami. Brothers, our Swami is so loving and compassionate that he loves each and every one equally, that even though he's having so much work, he loves everyone with equal importance. That is the first point I would like to mention. And then I would like to ask you all a question that, like, without you expressing your problems, no one can solve it. Be it your parents itself, like, if you don't express what your problems are, nobody can solve it. But brothers, our Swami is there, is so compassionate that without we expressing our problems also, who is our Hrudayavasi, he comes to know of our problems and solves it. For instance, we have a building beside our hostel building known as Vidyadi. That is a great example for his love, because in 6th when we came here, we never had this Vidyadi building, and we used to have lunch in the opposite building near the state high school. And we used to have our bhajans near Premdeep. Like, whatever the situation it may be, like it was full sunny or rainy, we used to go till there and have our food and come back. And no one had the thought that we'll ask for Swami a new building and he'll grant us that. No one had that thought. He said, "We'll adjust." So one auspicious day, Swami graciously said that, "Okay, I'm not able to see the plight of the CBSE students walking across the road, in whatever condition it may be, I could not see them suffering. So I would like to build a new building known as Vidyadeep, just beside their hostel. That is the love we never expressed, but his love is so bountiful. He only gave us the building. And now we have that building beside just our hostel and very easy to go. And his love, I cannot speak, words are not coming to describe his love. It's so infinite. I would like to narrate a small touching story about Swami's love. There was a very wealthy person known as Ben Abu Adam. He used to love his fellow beings and serve. And he used to never have that ego that he's the richest, and never used to keep everything to himself. He used to love the poor and help the needy. So one day what happened is, in the afternoon, two angels were discussing about something. So when Ben Abu Adam asked them what they're discussing about, they said that they were preparing a list of devotees who and all love God. So when Ben Abu Adam asked that, is my name there in the list? The angels replied that, no, your name is not there. Then Ben Abu Adam felt very disappointed. And then after 2 days went by, again one day when he got up from his bed, those two angels appeared in front of him and again they were discussing something. When Ben Abu Adam asked them what they were discussing about, they said that this time your name has come first in the list who God loves the devotees. That time he felt so happy and felt that it is because I serve the fellow beings and that is why God loves me. And Swami also wants that we all must serve our fellow beings and love them. And that is why he is educating us to love each and everyone. It should start from our class, then to the state, then to the nation, then to the whole world. We must always love, love, love. Like Swami always gives, gives, gives and forgives. We must also inculcate Swami. Like Swami said that, Na kumarulu. His student should be like his reflection. And Swami, with a small prayer, I would like to conclude. If I'm standing here, the strength in me is you, Swami. If I'm speaking, the words in me is you, Swami. Whatever I am today is you, Swami. Whatever I'll be tomorrow is also you, Swami. Whatever I was yesterday also is you. So always keep me with you and protect us and keep us all with you. And we must be your devotees and loving students always. And bless us, Swami. Jai Sai Ram.